if there's anyone that could start a really confident and peaceful spirit in your home, that's you. Because you set the tone, you set the atmosphere for your home. If there's anything to concentrate on, I feel like kasi what as parents, we feel like controlling the kid na parang the kid must feel this way, the kid must react this way, without really first checking ourselves. Ano nga ba talaga yung nararamdaman natin? Kasi sa atin din naman sila kukuha ng cue on how to react and take in things. We are the moral compass of our children. And so, we must remember that if the child is reacting a certain way, maybe it reflects something about you. Maybe it's your anxiety, it's your fears. And so, it's best talaga to go back and say, ano nga ba yung siniset ko na example for my children? That's one. But also, I don't want to burden you naman by saying na you're not supposed to be anxious, you're not supposed to be fearful. Because the truth is, it really can get scary at times, especially when we watch the news or when we hear of stories here and there na may namatay, may ganito. Syempre, nakaka-anxious naman din talaga yun. And I feel like that's also a good way to model to your children. Like, let's just be honest to them. You know, I'm getting scared about this and that because I've been hearing stories here and there that haven't been very encouraging for mama or for papa. And so I get anxious and I get scared about that. And I feel like when you say that to your children, it also tells them na, you know what, to be anxious and to be fearful is actually normal. Hindi naman kasalanan kung matakot ka eh. But it's what you do afterwards. It's more important that you're anxious and you're scared. But there is something else that you can do. And for us, our family, it's praying to God.
Ako una, siguro kausapin ninyo yung mga anak ninyo. Ito yung time na lahat tayo nasa mga bahay natin at may pagkakataon tayong mas makilala pa yung mga anak natin. Lalo na po kung kayo ay working parents na lagi kayong wala sa bahay noon at ngayon ito may time tayo na nasa tahanan tayo kasama natin mga anak natin. Mas kilalanin natin sila sa paraan na pinakamadali sa kanila, pinakamaluwag sa loob nila. Kapag nakilala na ninyo yung mga anak ninyo ng lubusan habang magkakasama tayo ngayon, dito na pumapasok yung bonding yun na pampalakas na at pampakapit pa ng connection ninyo bilang magulang sa anak. Ito yung time na pwede nating gawin yon. Ako ang advice ko po sa inyo, kilalanin niyo yung mga anak ninyo, mag-adjust po kayo sa mga gusto nilang gawin at suportahan niyo yon. Kasi dun sila na empower bilang tao And our children are much like us. Ako parang feeling ko nga hindi na ako tumanda, parang naiwan na ako dun sa panahon na I always want to learn and it really helps me as a person because feeling ko if you already know everything that you need to know in life at feeling mo alam mo na lahat yon, wala ka nang pagkakataon na kilalanin yung ibang tao para makatulong sa'yo. We should never put ourselves in a box even when we are at home and that's how it feels like na parang nasa isang box ka and you cannot move, you cannot grow. That's not the whole thing. The idea is while you're in a box, nasa inyong tahanan kayo, color that box. Make sure that it's an interesting box. It's a box that your family will want to be in. Make it a home that your family will want to be inspired with and, you know, create ideas with and para hindi mapigilan yung flow of creativity. At kahit hindi ka sobrang creative na tao, yung mga bagay na makakapagpasaya sa pamilya mo habang may pinagdadaanan kayo.
Gusto ko lang kayong bigyan ng pampatatag ng looban na lagi na lang tayong maging grateful. Maging mapasalamat din tayo sa meron tayo ngayon. Kasi kung sino yung sobrang magpasalamat, kung grateful ka talaga sa buhay mo, ikaw yung pinakamasayang tao sa buong mundo. Tingnan natin lahat ng mga bagay na pwede nating ipagpasalamat. Kahit na minsan, kasi ang utak iba din talaga, umatake ang utak eh. Minsan na nagumagano na tayo, ano nangyayari sa mundo? Ganito na ba? Pero mga mamshi, kapit lang talaga tayo kay God. Wala tayong ibang kakapitan kundi si God. At tingnan na lang natin ang sitwasyon na safe ang anak natin, safe tayo, approved na tayo nun. Kasi health is wealth talaga. Walang makakatumbas ng kaligtasan ng health mo, kundi walang makakatumbas sa mga pera, mga fame. Basta healthy ang mga anak mo, approve na yan. Na-prove yan natin ngayong crisis na ito. Kaya maging grateful na lang tayo and huwag tayong mawala ng pag-asa. Kumapit tayo kay God dahil malalampasan natin itong lahat. Basta lagi tayong magdasal.
One tip that I always do to myself and I will always tell to all my friends or the people that will ask me, even though you might be feeling bad or you might be overwhelmed or you might be stressed or you have no certainty of what's happening in the world, never show it to your kid. Why? Because they do not understand and they need to feel secure right now by their parents. I know like sometimes it's very hard and you cannot control it, but it's very hard for a kid to know that they might be not protected or they might be like in a stress situation. I know that it's very hard, like just try to make your child feel secure and protected.
Do everything one step at a time. Yung daughter ko, kinuha namin ngayon lahat yung gadgets niya. So now, she's forced to go back to her painting, to her crafts. Sa ngayon, kasi kahit gusto mong ilayo yung isip mo sa mga toxic na pangyayari, hindi mo maiwasan. Ang payo ko lang sa mga parents, to moms especially who are hands-on with their children at home, is to just focus on the things that you can control and not to dwell on the ones that you cannot. With the kids, make do with whatever is at home. Huwag na natin sabihin na, nako, kung wala lang pandemic, sana nandun na tayo ngayon or ito yung ginagawa natin. Just be in the present in what's happening. Kung wala silang time noon to do other things, maybe we should encourage our kids to read more, to discover more about their talents by making use of whatever they have at home. Si Olivia nga, minsan paliliguan ko yan sa palanggana eh. Kasi ganun lang ginagawa namin noon eh. I want her to experience the joy of yung simplicity. Just be in the now and do not overthink. Do everything to be healthy. Pray every night. As soon as you wake up in the morning, pray for a lot of people, pray for your family, pray for yourself, and have that quiet time once in a while. That's the best thing that I can advise to you.
Be honest with what's going on. Explain to them thoroughly. Secure them by also giving hope to them that in time, things will get better. And then be responsible. They also have a part, even if they're just little kids. One is for them to be responsible in washing their hands. And then be responsible with helping around the house. Getting their minds busy also, rather than having to dwell and think of it so much that it affects them. So get them involved in cleaning the house, washing the dishes, or whatever it is, para maging productive pa rin yung day nila, kahit na they're at home. It is a good time to really come together as a family and pray, teach them about being faithful to the Lord, even during times wherein things are uncomfortable. If I summarize everything, I've been making my children do chores. Don't allow your mind to be idle. There's a lot of things that you can do at home that you can help. Volunteer in helping. Learn something new. If you're not interested in drawing, maybe there's a special skill that you want to learn. Maybe something that you've been putting off that you can do. And then helping with our frontliners, writing letters to them. Children are writing letters, helping us pack the PPEs, writing on the balikbayan boxes. We also put a face shield together. These things are productive things, and tell them that, you know, I may be young, but I can do something also to help. Whether it be staying at home and doing chores and helping my parents and helping our kasambahays, or helping and preparing food for them.